There's one more refinement to the algorithm that I can't resist, and that's due to Dinic. He actually published his algorithm in 1970, 2 years before Edmonds Carr. His key insight is that the work of computing the shortest path can be recycled so that a full recomputation only needs to happen when the shortest path distance changes, not for every augmenting path.
As with all augmenting path strategies, we start with an initial flow of zero. Then we repeat the following. We build the level graph from the residual flow network and let k be the shortest path length from s to t. Then, while there's a path from source to sink in the level graph that has length k, we'll augment the flow along that path and then update the residual capacities. And we repeat this until there are no more st paths in the residual network. And finally, we just return the flow. Turning to the analysis, we'll call one iteration of this outer loop a phase, and we'll be able to argue that each phase increases the length of the shortest st path in the residual network by 1. The principle here is the same as for Edmonds Karp. Augmenting by a shortest path flow doesn't create a shorter augmenting flow. Hence, once we've exhausted all paths of a given length, the next shortest path must be one edge longer. Within a phase, the level graph is built by breadth-first search, so that only costs order e time. The hardest part of the argument will be that this loop altogether takes only e times v time. We'll see this argument in a second. Altogether, we will show that Dinic's algorithm takes e times v squared time, which is an improvement over the e squared v time of Edmonds Karp.